Last night, first time that I realized the glow between us felt so right. We sat on the edge of the bed and you said, I never knew that I could feel this way. Love today can be so difficult, but what we have I know is different. When I'm with you, the world stops turning. Could I love you anymore? Could I love you anymore? Could I love you anymore? Sunrise time flies, feels like a dream. Being close, inhaling, hard to believe. 7 billion people in the world, finding you is like a miracle. Only this wonder remains. Could I love you anymore? Could I love you anymore? Could I love you anymore? Mm-hmm. Softly, slowly, love unfolding. Could this love be true? Could I love you anymore? Could I love you anymore? Could I love you anymore? Could I love you anymore?
The question's rhetorical.
Could I love you anymore?
Does this feel phenomenal?
Could I love you anymore?
Love is all.
Could I love you anymore?
It's inexhaustible.
Could I love you?
Could I love you anymore? Could I love you anymore? Could I love you anymore?
So don't you dare look back. Just keep your eyes on me. I said you're holding back. She said shut up and dance with me. This woman is my destiny. She said fading light.
Honestly, though, where he has struck gold is our fantastic and very talented Josephine.
To be celebrating the marriage of two awesome people. Graham and Joe, I remember when you were in the early stages of your relationship and it was immediately clear that you had an enormous amount of love and respect for each other. This has only grown stronger over time and will continue to do so. It has been so wonderful to see you both so happy and content. Graham, you are certainly the partner for Joe. Game, set, and match. Yeah. Woo!
Firstly, I'd just like to welcome you all here. It's such an honour for Josephine and I to have all of our wonderful friends and family here tonight. I could say workmates as well, but really I think all of you workmates are actually friends. So, you know. I'm not normally one to blow my own trumpet, but I think I've done pretty well. You know, I was absolutely besotted with this woman. I'd never come across anyone like Josephine in my life. And so I thought, right, you can make 10,000 concrete blocks, Wunderos, you can solve this problem. Of determination and a lot of love, I managed to convince Josephine that I really was completely in love with her and that she was the best thing that I'd ever seen. And Ash told the story of the Cook's Beach soiree down to the digging up the ring in the sand, and Josephine did say that she would marry me, and so now I'm here and I'm the happiest guy in town. Woo! It's just so good that you've all come to join us, and I hope you all have a really good night.
I'd always said I wouldn't do this again. That was, of course, until I met that man over there, Graham, and fell head over heels in love with him. And when he asked me to marry him, of course I said yes without hesitation. I've married the most incredible, beautiful human being you could ever meet. And so many of you know that to be true. But also, it was a great excuse to throw a big party. Get two sets of friends and our families together, and you know how I love to throw a party. I found the love of my life. And I'm just so happy today. And I want to thank you all for coming this evening. And I just want to hand over to my beautiful youngest son, Michael, who wanted to say a final few words on Rose.
First, I was a little bit, you know, worried or scared, but I realized that, and I've mentioned this a few times to a few people, that if I wanted anyone to be my stepdad, you know, marry my mum, it would be Grant, 100%. I don't see Graham as, you know, the guy who just comes in out of nowhere and steals the fatherhood, you know. I see him as a genuine friend of mine. We have the same interests, same hobbies, and we both love the same person. And that sort of goes with all the kids down there on the kids' table. Because I've grown up with these guys, we've traveled around the world with these guys, and I don't think of them as friends or family friends or step-siblings or friends of friends. I think of them as family members, you know? True family members, and I love all of them.
Having split parents is really hard, but Joe and the Wallace boys really make it worth it. I love them so much.
The story really does have a fairy tale ending. Graham, the nicest guy ever, meets Josephine, the nicest girl ever. They get married happily in front of all their family friends on this perfect day and this perfect venue. However, we know this isn't really the end of that story. It's really just the beginning. So if you'd be upstanding one last time, please, folks, to show your love and support for this gorgeous couple that are now embarking on the rest of their lives together. To Graham and Josephine. Now that ends the formal part of the evening. I know the band that's coming up is epic, so I encourage everybody to get on the dance floor. Maybe not Chris. And we'll go from there. Have a great night, folks.
From my my lonely days are gone. Give it to me.